I feel like a lot of old school wrestling fans have such a problem with Orange Cassidy, even though sometimes it feels like he's doing things that they would like. And working with him, talk about the experience or the idea of sort of picking him and going, I want to work with this guy who's maybe divisive.
So I learned very early on. It actually happened to me in 2016 when I went back to WWE, and like I'd be working with Seth Rollins, and Seth Rollins would do three topes in a row. I was like, what the f*** are you doing? Like, in my day, you do one tope, and that's it. You don't do three topes in a row. And then I realized, hey, get your head out of your ass. This is the way it is now. Learn from it. Get better because of it. Same thing with AEW when we first started. I didn't know half the roster. I literally didn't, because it was mostly indie guys. I follow, obviously, online and read, you know, Dirt Sheet or whatever, but, you know, I didn't know who Darby Allin was. You know, I didn't know who Orange Cassidy is. And so Orange Cassidy comes in, and I was watching him going, like, yeah, obviously your initial thing is, this sucks. Like, this is stupid. He's going to stand there, he's, you know, his hands in his pockets, and he's kicking you. I got to sell this. Like, and then I'm like, head out of ass. The guy's over. So, answer me this, Chris, talking to myself. Why is he over? I really started watching. The guy's a genius. Like, all the stuff that he does. And I asked him, why? Where'd you come up with this? He said, because I was a high flyer that was not a high flyer. Like, I'm doing indies with the Bucks and, you know, freaking all these guys. And I'm like, I'm not doing anything great. If I don't change, I'm just another guy. So instead of trying to do all the moves, let me just do none of the moves and just be lazy. And I was like, that takes a lot of commitment to get that over. And I really started appreciating the genius of Orange Cassidy. And that's when I was like, I really want to work with this guy. I think I could have some fun with him. Only problem was, it was lockdown. Flatten the curve. I wanted to work with Jungle Boy too, but I was like, he's so popular with the crowd, let me wait till the crowds come back. A year later, it was like, it's done, you know? So that we did 14 weeks with Orange and Chris, and I loved it. The only thing I hate was the fact there was no people in the audience, but there was people watching at home. They did great ratings. It's like, we had no choice. You can't just put everything on hold. So working with him, we did a lot of great stuff. If you go back to that angle, and like I said, culminating in the Mimosa Mayhem, which you might look at it on the surface and go, that's stupid. It's actually pretty cool. I got the idea from FMW where they'd have the explosive bombs outside of the ring. And the guys would be on the side of the ring, like going like this. And oh, and if they fall into the explosive, it blows up, right? And you could tease that and just be like, oh. And finally, the guy falls into the bomb and explodes up. That was the idea that I had with the Mimosa Mayhem. We could tease going into this, you know, in this orange juice and champagne, like, all match. And then finally someone takes a bump in it, and there's your winner. And I still think that was pretty cool, especially for the time, especially with him. He is the orange juice guy, right? I'm the bubbly guy. Get it, guys? That's what a mimosa is. Orange juice, bubbly, Jericho, Orange Cassidy, right? So I really, really liked working with him. And the guy can work. He's really, really good. So my favorite thing I did with him was we did the debate, and he never talked. And I said, wouldn't it be great if you just come up with some like huge speech about, you know, climate change, you know, or, you know, and so he wrote up this thing. He put the piece of paper down on the podium, and I was like, some question, and then I was like, you know, what are you going to say, Orange? And he just goes, well, the Ethereum of the integral and the blah, 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 and the signal, and he just read this whole thing, and it was just like people that were in the crowd, which was 40 people, went nuts for it. I was like, this is so good. He finally talks, and he says this big, long, you know, the soliloquy about climate change. But great guy, great performer, and he's got nothing but respect from me. And that's when I was like, I'll never go past second match here in WWE. Like, this is kind of the best story. It's the best time. My character's super hot. The list was hot. All that stuff was hot. And second, that's it. And I was like, I'm done. So that's kind of where I made the decision to, like, I don't really want to work here anymore.